Trading meme coins and brand new tokens before they get listed on centralized exchanges can make you a lot of money. But one of the biggest disadvantages of doing so is that you cannot set limit orders, because this is usually a function that only a centralized trading platform can offer. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set limit orders with the Solana Trading Bot. If you don't already have the Solana Trading Bot installed, then I'll leave a link in the description so that you can add it to your Telegram application. To set limit orders on crypto tokens, you first need to open the Solana Trading Bot inside of Telegram. The next thing that you want to do is head down to the message line and you want to type /start and hit enter. And before we start, you want to make sure that you have a wallet. So just click on the wallets button, and you can see under wallets that I have two wallets already and they're both funded. If you don't have a wallet, then you want to generate a new wallet and you want to make sure that you get that funded. Then you can go back to the other menu, just hit the close button. From the start menu, you just want to look for the button that says limit orders and left click on that button. And we get a message, you have no active limit orders, create a limit order from the buy and sell menu. So the limit order button is just so that you can check on your active limit orders. So let's close this. All right, and then we're gonna left click on buy and sell. All right, and next we need to paste the token contract to begin the buy and sell. So for this example, we're going to use a random coin. I have chosen Costco hot dog. I'm just going to copy the contract address and minimize the page and then paste in the token address, Control V, and press enter or click the arrow icon. And now we have a list of all the buy and sell options. So let's start at the top. We're in buy mode. So if you are already holding the token, you want to click on sell mode and make sure that that is green, but we don't have the token yet. So I'm going to go into buy mode. And then you have to decide between swap, limit, and DCA. Since we're placing a limit order, we want to click on limit, make sure it's green. Now I have two wallets and I want to use the second wallet. So I'm going to left click on the second wallet and I'm going to unselect the first wallet. And now we need to set the trigger price. So the trigger price is the price at which the limit order will be executed. And you can set this as a number or you can set a percentage. So I'm going to left click on trigger price and I'm going to change the trigger price to the price I want to enter at. So I'm going to choose 0.03 and then press enter. All right, and you can see that the trigger price has been updated. Now we want to set the expiry date. So you can decide how long you want the limit order to stay open for. To change it from 1 day, you're just going to left click on it. And then you can choose the increment from the available options, which are seconds, minutes, hours, and days. So I'm going to change the expiry to 7 days. To do that, you type in 7 and the letter D, no spaces, and hit enter. All right, and you can see that the expiry has been updated. Now we have to set the limit buy amount. You can choose from the pre-filled amounts, or you can set a custom buy amount by clicking on the limit buy XSOL. So left click on that, and then we'll enter 0.3 and hit enter. And that option is now selected and it's in green. We have configured all the limit options for this buy. So we're going to preview the order, left click on preview order. And on the preview limit orders, you just want to confirm that all the information is correct. Check the current price of the token that you're setting the limit order for, and then the price at which you want to buy or sell, as well as the expiry and the wallet that you're using. One thing to take note is that you don't want to just create a bunch of limit orders that you don't intend on using. Yes, you can cancel the limit orders after creating them, but unlike a centralized exchange platform, you will get charged a small fee for creating limit order contracts. These fees are charged regardless of whether your limit order gets executed or not. So if you're okay with that, then you want to left click on create order now, and you get a message submitting limit order from the wallet being used. This will just take a couple of seconds to process, and then we'll get a confirmation. And we just got a message saying create order transaction has succeeded. And if you want to check that transaction, you can click on the word transaction and that will take you to SolScan to take a look at the order details such as the amount and the fees. So now your limit order is waiting for execution. Basically, once it reaches your desired price, this contract will execute. And you can check your orders at any time by typing /limit orders. All right, and the trading bot says that I have no active limit orders, but that's because by default, wallet one is selected. We just need to select wallet two. All right, and you can see that we have an active limit order, 1 of 1. And the limit order is a buy for Costco hot dog. And if at any time you decide that you don't want the limit order anymore, you can click the close button. Just keep in mind, as I said before, you get charged for creating the limit order and you also get charged a transaction fee for closing the limit order. The Solana trading bot has a lot of powerful tools that can allow you to trade tokens automatically. If you like this video and want to learn how to buy tokens before they have even launched, then click the video on the screen now or check the description of this video to learn how to configure the sniper.